My name is Babak Basiri, and today we are here at the University of Georgia College of Pharmacy. I'm a PhD graduate student, a third-year PhD student of pharmaceutical and biomedical sciences. The general theme in our lab is essentially measurement. So what we're trying to do is to measure stuff, mainly biological stuff. We biologists are not very keen about exact measurements. And that's not good. If a science like physics made it to the state it is today, that was because of the exact measure. It was essentially very tiny variations from the expected data that influenced the physicists to come up with all these new theories to explain those variations. While in the field of biology, we usually attribute those to the differences in biological systems and as a sort of, if you call it, noise. So that was the reason I joined this lab, because I think it is important that we as biologists start doing more exact measurements and see what they mean. Liquid chromatography and also mass spectrometry. What I measure are essentially nucleic acids. So nucleic acids are what our genes are made of. Essentially, the DNA is what our genes are made of, and they are nucleic acids. But we also have another class of nucleic acids, RNA molecules. And the good thing about RNA molecules is that they are readily available to be used as drugs. Sure, so that's why we are interested. Usually measure them as two enzymatic reactions. And again, as a sort of biological experiment, is not very exact. So we can see relative differences. We can say, okay, this sample has more RNA than that sample. But we can never attribute a very exact number to those with the enzymatic reactions that
I'm
interested in producing exact numbers for the levels of nucleic acids in cells in the body. These are endogenous molecules. We have started using them as pharmaceutical agents. But our body makes a lot of them. And some of them actually can be used to see if we are at the state of health or if there's a pathological condition, there's a disease going on. Right now, we have three drugs that are oligonucleotides on the market. I know, that's not so many, only three. But they have been only used as drugs in the past 10 years. So we're expecting to see more. And that's why I'm interested in the field, because I think that's going to be an important field in the future. The first time I liked biology. Big part of it was essentially dissecting frogs and looking at different organs in frogs. Part of the lab was to figure out if we have a male frog or a female frog. And that wasn't difficult. You open it up, you can see if it has ovary or if it has testes. But then I remember one time we just opened up this frog, we took out the ovaries and we hid them, and then we were like, "Well, science, sir, there's this frog here, we can't identify if he's a male or a female." And I just started digging into it, trying to find out what's going on, and he was really persistent. That took him like 10 minutes, and we were like, "Yeah, you know, we kind of hit over it." That was just a joke. And yeah, that was a real good time that I had in the biology. But what is missing in biology is the measurements, the exact numbers, the exact theories. Because evolution is a great theory, essentially. I think we should start moving to in biology, the theories that generate exact numbers, and then see if those theories work fine or not. That's probably the future of biology. Thank you.